So instead of just trying to go over each and every little thing I've made one by one left to right, I'm going to opt to do this a little bit more organically, just to show you just how you could implement something like this into your workflow. So starting off, all right, so this is actually a little bit of the audio I was actually doing for this video within Logic Pro X, but I wanted to try to see how doing this within OBS Studio would work. So for right now, you know what, why don't I just close this. We'll open up a new project here. And by the way, I don't have this within this profile, but you could totally automate this onto the Stream Deck, put a button that says open new file and just press in it and it would open up. Just do new. All right. Oh, that's right. Logic demands that you have some kind of thing from the beginning. So I'm just going to open a software instrument. But obviously, you know, you're making music. I doubt that you're making any kind of thing with just one track. So here, I'm going to show you what you can do here. Let me get this smaller so you can see the Stream Deck. Okay. I'm going to get rid of the library thing here. Just make the page a little bit wider. All right, so I've got this in front. Let's say I want a whole bunch more tracks. I have it at basic functions, new track, and then software instrument. Oh, do I not have these in yet?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, I don't know why. I guess I had just set these up without them being on there. So this is as good as time as any to show you, okay, so you can kind of command this however you want with the Stream Deck Pro, so right? So basically how you do this is you got these buttons on the Stream Deck where you can, you know, I can make a folder, sometimes you can make an action with multiple things happening, but I'm going to go to like system hotkey, right? And then you would put in the hotkey, which for whatever program, so let's say for Logic, right? So the standard hotkey for a new instrument track is command option S, right? So if I put that into there, which I have right here, I'm just going to remove the title because I already have it right there. But now I have that command locked in, and so now whenever I press software instrument track, boom, I can get a whole bunch. Audio track, right? So let's look up new audio track. It's the same thing but with A, right? So command option A, boom. Now, many of you guys out there might already be used to some of these key commands, and you can, that's fine, you can keep using them. For me, I was never much of a person who did those kind of things, which is why the Stream Deck was such a great thing for me, because I could have that, you know, fast response, but with something a little bit more accessible, and I didn't have to memorize all these different keystrokes. So, okay, command, yeah. So if I go here, audio, let me get that out of the way, audio. Awesome. All right, I'm just going to delete these because we don't need them for now. Well, actually, we might. And then let me just mute it for the time being.
Wow.
Cool. So let me actually just kind of record something in here. And if you can see here, I can just go on basic functions if I want. You guys probably already, you know, it's just tap R, so you don't really need to program this in. I just, you know, I got carried away when using this thing. I think it's just such a cool tool. And you might already have some kind of MIDI controller where you have, you know, buttons mapped out or anything. But yeah, so I can just go on the record and press record or whatever if I want. So I'm just going to record a little audio, and we're just going to experiment a little bit to see, showing you what this does. Oh, also, you need to have whatever program it is in front in order for the buttons to work. Okay, cool. Now I'm recording, and it is picking up something. I'm just going to talk for a bit, blah, 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 and let's stop it. All right. Now I can go on to, instead of just dragging for the zoom thing, I was never good with Logic's zoom tools, so I'm going to try this. I'm going to go on that. Now see, I'm on zoom functions. I'm going to press zoom functions. And there's a bunch. So I have basic. Let's do basic. And I'm just going to click on zoom vertical in. There's zoom vertical out, so then zoom horizontal, zoom vertical. So that's a basic way you can just get it. So those are kind of ones by increment. So let me zoom out again. So now I'm zoomed out. Let me see if there's... okay. So zoom to fit locators. So if I get the locators thing, so you can just press U around a highlighted track. But let me do... let me see this zoom to fit locators. Great. So now it kind of blasts it up. And now if I really want to see that waveform, I can go back to basic zoom functions here and then just zoom vertical in, because we want it to go up. We really want to see the wave file. And there it is. Cool. So, and there's like a lot of zoom functions that I have on there, but something like that for me already makes it faster than just using the zoom sliders, which is what I had been doing for so long. I'm such a ineffective person when it comes to workflow, so this Stream Deck has really saved me. So all right, cool. So now we can go to the audio arranging functions here. I'm just going to click on that. Let me see what we got here. So I can, let me see, let's do add audio crossfade, see if that does anything. Oh, and it brings up the preferences for merge and crossfade. So I might have to look at that one again. So Whoa. Some of these I gotta tinker with a bit. Let's try strip silence. Okay, brings up, press the button, brings up the strip silence thing. Boom, I did strip silence. Let me just undo that now. So, easy way to bring up things that are kind of hidden away in menus that are a bit, you know, that might take 10 seconds to kind of look for and click on. And in long term, that saves you a lot of time. So here we have the trim to transients tool. So basically, if you're trying to edit certain parts of your audio to hit certain transients, this will be a nice little thing. So I can trim region start to previous transient, but we don't have a previous transient because it's like it's the first thing, right? We can trim region end to previous transient. Okay, so it's starting from the it's talking about both ends, right? So to previous transient, right? So if we had a transient over here, it trims it. Now if we can do that same thing on the opposite side. Oops, let me get that. Like that, by pressing the trim region start to next transient. And then once you do that, I can do the opposite, right? I can bring those transients back by pressing the trim region end to next transient. So that's really nifty. You can basically, instead of using your mouse, you can find a pesky transient almost by just kind of like nudging it along the clip. Which is much more effective and less time consuming than, you know, going in and finding the transient, marking it down, and adjusting things, which you can do. Obviously, this is not a thing that's going to work for everything, but for basic edits where you don't have to mess with the transients too much, you can use this to kind of get the region exactly to where you want it to go according to the transient you want it to start or end on. Cool. Let me see what else. Trim region. Yeah, so I have a lot of interesting things here. I just kind of want to go through the basic ones, so I'm going to get off this one. Let's look at the audio file editor. Nice. All right, so what the audio file editor is this thing. If you press on E, right, and it brings up the file thing. So I can go on here, file options, you know, save it, delete it, create a backup, whatever. I don't need to do this. So we could do play stop all, play stop region from anchor. So if you put an anchor in a certain spot, like let's say you anchor it here, it would start and play from there. Yeah, you have to, and when you do these, you have to make sure you're on the file, actually on the file tab. So play stop all, there it goes. Okay. Go to. So I can go to the region start. I can go to the region end. We can do set selection. So I can set the selection. So you have to place a transient first. So I can have that start. And then I can have over here be the end of that transient point. Oh, whoops, I selected start twice. Let me. Oops, I want you to be over here. And I want you to start here, right? And I want us to go over here. And let's say I want to end it here. I can say set selection end. There. So this is what I was doing before with the region itself, but now I'm doing it within the file editor, so where I can, you know, make this a longer section that I have going. I can get it to go to the part of a start of a previous transient. I can even move the entire selection. Yeah, you can toggle the transient edit mode right here. Pretty useful. You can select all following, select all previous. Also really useful. You can even apply fades within the file. So I can do a fade in if I wanted to. Just remember that this is doing stuff within a file can be destructive depending on the function. I can trim in certain spots. So if I go here, oh, I think I need to be in within the transient here. Trim. See, I select area, I can trim it, boom, press of a button. I can invert it, same thing, just by pressing that. Reverse it, same thing. It's got volume options. Yeah, really useful stuff within the file editor itself. Let's go out of here and go back. Let me just get this out of the way. Let's go back onto the main track area, and let's kind of look at the nudge and value things. So one of the things many times, especially if you're well, in any kind of music, but especially for kind of doing things for film and TV, getting things to land on exactly, like, not even milliseconds, but smaller than that for frames and subframes, you're going to need certain snap values to work. So here, I can go... Oh, I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking. I need to bring that back up. So if I go on the nudge ruler and SMPTE functions, let me see if I can zoom. I think it's a bit zoomed out to where you can't see some of these things. So let me just show you what I got there. So I have nudge values here, snap values functions, nudge region event, secondary ruler, and then lock and unlock SMPTE positions. All right, so if I go here, and I go on nudge values, right? Can we see the... I'm going to have to expand this so we can see the value stuff. All right, so we got... Right, so here's the snap thing. I have one for the nudge values. So this is basically if I want to nudge something, right? So nudge values. There's... nudge values are basically the same as snap values. You can do smart, bar, beat, division, ticks, frames. But then you can also go by milliseconds and things like that. Okay, so now you didn't see it because it's the nudge thing is actually, this is the snap menu. So it wouldn't have shown anything. But if I click on the measure and if I go back to one folder up, and now I'm clicking on the nudge region event, and now I can nudge it left or right, or right or left, I'm sorry, and I can even make the length be nudged by that amount. Except this one doesn't seem to be doing what I want. I want it to... Oh, maybe if I do this. Huh? That's the one. Ah, I see. I accidentally pressed the wrong one. This should be shift option right. Now let's do it. There we go. See? Very cool. And I could, if I go back here, right? Nudge values. Oh, I think it was just for divisions wasn't working. That's right, I didn't have. So now I can set it to beats. So let's do beats. And the same thing will apply. All right, cool. Now the nudge value is beats. Going back, nudge region event. Boom. Now we're going by beats, and I can affect the region length by beats. That's useful. Maybe, you know, the first half of the bar was good, but then things started going wanky, and that later half, boom, boom, there it's gone. Okay? Cool. So, and then also it has snap. So now you might be able to see this on snap. So see that? If you look here on where it says snap. Hold on, let me go over here. Do I have this zoomed in to where? Okay, yeah, it's the full video. Sorry about that. So if we go here to snap, now I'm pressing value beats, or I'm sorry, value divisions, beat, bar, ticks, frames, So for SMPTE frames, so when you're doing things for a film. So now let me do snap to beats. Now when I drag, it's wanting to snap. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me do, now it's on beats. Now when I snap, it wants to go to different beats in the measure. Now if I do ticks, that's going to be really small. I don't know if you can. Right, so it basically looks like nothing's happening, but that's because the rate of division is so small. Let's do bars. Now it's going to be very evident, right? Well, it's moving like this because I actually didn't have it set up. Let me go back to beats. And now I can get it to the beginning of the bar there. Let me extend this region a bit so that it just for. Just to kind of show you what I'm doing here. Okay, so now we got it to where we want it, and now if I go back to bar, boom, 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 boom. Cool. And then, I gotta look at the lock, SMPTE. Cool, and now when I press it, unlocked, locked, unlocked. Very cool. Yeah, let's keep going. So there's that. Zoom, automation stuff. I can toggle automation in and out here. If I go on A, right, it's showing toggling the read, latch or read, and automated quick action, but I haven't defined it yet. So, I need to also just make a button to toggle all. I'm just going to do this just to toggle. I didn't put it in there because I use a. It's a very simple key command just to toggle everything. But so you don't have to if you don't want to. I'm just going to show toggle just automation in general. And then now, right, it's just showing us everything. Right, so automation. Cool. And then you can even do something like set all tracks. So you can do something very cool. You can even set all tracks to read, to off, to touch, to latch. So, you know, if you have something bigger going on, you can set them all. And then you could even, let me just kind of record a little MIDI part here. Okay, so I've got a little, I'm just gonna mute my microphone. The microphone part here. Cool. So now I'm going to go on automation toggle. Let me zoom in a bit here. Oh, we're on. I don't want that. I want just the normal one here, not lash, not that, just normal. It's okay. Cool. Now we're on read. I can do some other cool things. I can do create automation point at the region borders. So you got to make sure it's selected. Boom. It does it at the border. So if I wanted to do, you know, like a basic lift of the region, very simple. Or if, you know, if you just wanted to make this crescendo or decrescendo, also very easy to do. All right, So now, let me highlight all of these. Go back to our automation thing. And I can, let me automate this one first. So let's do that. Let's have it go there and there for the volume, whatever. Now, okay, so now what's cool is that I can actually just get this into the region itself, which is awesome. It gets rid of a lot of clutter, it makes everything really cool, but I can also bring it back to the track. And I can actually put all region data onto track automation and all region data back to the track itself. You can't see it here because I wasn't doing anything with an external controller or anything. All I was doing the volume. But you could get all of that data showing just only on the region, or you could bring it up onto the track itself. Selection tools. Yes, this is really cool. Yes. Let me zoom out of everything here. So, let me deselect all. So, select all. I can do select all following, too. So, all right. So, here's this. Select all following. Boom. Cool. Let me do invert selection, which is really nice. So yeah, let's say I have a track up here. So I could just simply do select all following, simple enough. But what if I just wanted on this track there? And you can see that. So there's select all following inside the locators. Or select a following of the same track position. Let's say I have this over here. Okay, but I want to select this, select all inside locators, so that's going to bring it vertically to whatever is. So I have these two selected, but I also want to have these guys selected. Select all inside locators, boom, now they're there, that's right. Here. Sorry if some of the things I'm actually doing aren't showing up, but that's because, here, let me move it over here so you can see. Once again, so I'm selecting. Now I want this to be selected as well. Select all inside locators, which is over here. Boom. And there's so many selection tools I have on here. I'm not going to go over them all. I have, you know, select similar region, select equal one, select the same subposition. Really useful stuff. Now, personally, my favorite part, the organization one. I use this so much. Look at this. If I go over here, rename regions. Synth. Boom. They're all renamed if you've selected them all. What if I want it just to be what the track says? By track. So it went back to saying, because I pressed the button that said rename regions by track, now it's instrument 3 again, now it's instrument 4 again. Or now I can rename the tracks by the regions, but because it's a synth. Well, actually, let me just undo this. Now they all say synth, right? And now I can press this button that says rename the tracks by the regions. And it says it can't do it. Oh, yes, it did. Synth. Synth. Great, cool. Color regions. So when you've got a big project and you need to color things, right? So let me have the thing that brings open the... let's color regions by track color. Oh, okay, so I got to bring up the color itself here. And I can also just assign track color. Where do I have that? Ah, it's on the bottom here, assign track color. So first off, let's assign a track color right here. I want this to be blue. Oh, I'm sorry, that's assigned track icons, which is really cool. So let me just go over that. I want this synth. All right, color tracks. Whoops. It's over on my other window here. It's been bringing it up. All right, so yeah, let's have it be purple. Cool. So now I can do this. I can do color region by track colors. Boom. This thing is so useful for organization. And I can create track stacks. Let's do a sum stack. Boom. Just by one press of the button. Just by pressing these, create folder stack, create summing stack. You can recolor the regions. It makes organization. So let's say this is gonna be our synth folder thing, right? So boom, I did that. Once again, I want all of this thing to be purple. So I pressed that button. Boom, now we're all purple. What purple is that? It's more like, yeah, it's that purple. So now I can go here. All these guys, too. We're all going to be purple. Because we're going to be part of the stack here. Whoops, let me do... I got to get off of this initial color menu here. Bring this one up. See, now we're green. We're going to be purple. We're going to be purple. Cool. Brought that up. I want, now let's say I have a new region. It'll bring that up like that. But let's say I also bring this guy into the mix. Create MIDI region, except he's green, right? I don't want that. So first I gotta color my track like this again. But this guy's still purple. Or he's still green, but I want him purple. I can press the button that says color region by track color. Boom. So for organization, I love this thing. Then I'm just going to kind of quick go over some of the other things. Global positioning. This one's actually kind of cool. So for doing things with regions. So I can cut between the region locators. So see this? Region locators. Cut. So it cut out whatever was between those locators. I'm going to undo that now. So let's say I don't like this section. Cut. It's gone. And it moves everything between those areas too. So let me do that again. Cut. And now this part just snapped over to there. So if you want to just kind of move two sections together, boom, cut sections between locators, one press of a button, no remembering the keyboard macros. This thing is heaven. I can't love this thing enough. So I can add this region to the loop library by a press of a button. I can move regions to a selected track. Let's say I want this here. Boom, it goes there. Repeat section between locators. Awesome, I can just duplicate things. I can insert silence. I don't want anything here. Be gone. Very cool. Some of these, because apparently some of the things. Also, aliases, right? So this is an alias. These are aliases, so they're basically copies of an original one. So I can actually convert them into region copies, and I can select all the orphan aliases by pressing this button. So it says, oh, these guys are copies of you, and so it selects everything from that original thing. Cool, let me get out of this full screen mode here. Where'd Stream Deck go? And then over here, then we have the import, export, bounce, save functions. Very useful. Instead of just climbing the menus, you can boom, 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 press them. Basic functions, record, your metronomes, counting in, the new tracks, cycle through windows, new channels, copy channel strip settings, paste channel strip settings, which is useful if you're, you know, got a bunch of, for instance, like synth tracks, and you just want the same thing on each one. You could just copy and paste it instead of loading the same thing in and out again. Transport tools, go to measure function, always handy. Punch in and out. Markers, so this is really nice for creating markers, which are especially handy for, you know, film editing and things like that, where you need to, oh, this part of the scene, this part of the scene, and you can go to that. Locator functions, also very handy. So you can, you know, like, let's say I only want to move by the length of this. Look, now I'm moving only in these increments. I can, you know, by next marker, I could set rounded ones, and it shows up in that little thing there. So if I did like a whole big group of them too, it's not just individual ones, right? If I just did these guys, I could move them. Whoops, I could move them by that cycle. So, cool stuff. And then different modes. So I can get into cycle mode, solo mutes. Really useful. Auto punch mode, and then cycle windows, which is really nice. So mixer, boom. Here's the event list over here. Pressed a button, I got musical typing right here. They're all showing up on the other screen here, which is not necessarily conducive to making this video. Here's smart controls. Here's the smart control thing for loop browser. Oh, whoops, it's still on musical typing, that's why. Here's loop browser. Plugin windows. So if you have any plugins, they'll pop in and out. Let me see if I. Audio effects. Let's get, I don't know. Let's just get step effects. Now I can bring that up just by pressing the button on my Stream Deck controller. Yeah, the library button, region inspector. Let me close out of this. Edit windows, so step input. They're all popping on the other, my other window there. Step input, score editor. Staff style, if you're doing, you know, editing within Logic itself, you can, like you're doing score editing, you can pop those up as well. Mixer. Some basic things. Select all certain ones, create aux channels, that kind of thing, deselect all. Piano roll, so this is really awesome. I actually need to go in and make key commands for certain parts of these, but let me go on to the piano roll here. And I want all of these guys to basically hit to be played to their full values. So I can press the force legato button and it's gonna make them all go. See that? It snaps to within the appropriate amount of area that it should be. So, and it gets everything kind of tight and legato-esque. Just by pressing a button, a huge component of that time you've wasted dragging things is gone. You save so much time. But then I can go into the MIDI transform menu, and I haven't actually programmed some of these things in yet. I gotta get to doing that. You might not be able to make commands for certain things within Logic, but I highly recommend getting Keyboard Maestro, because what I can do instead is I can get around that and I can still get it to do some of the things that I want it to do. So I'm going to open up Keyboard Maestro here, and I'm going to make a new macro here. I'm just going to call it Logic Macros. And available in all? Nope, I want it only available in Logic. Now I'm going to make a new macro. I'm going to type this one fixed velocity. And I'm going to have it select or show a menu item. And we're going to do, once again, Logic Pro X. Edit. Navigate. Window. Open MIDI transform. Okay. Let's try it. Oh, there it goes. It opened. Let me see. Try it again. Yep, there it did. It opened it up. One of my favorite things that I have on here is the step input. And I don't know if you can see it. Let me get over here. Whoops, where did OBS go? There you are. So now, instead of doing the annoying thing where you have to, you know, hold one hand for the keyboard and stuff, you know, like six for a half note and four for an eighth note and things like that, you can simply have this relatively close to you, hold the button, press the key. It makes step input. It makes step input entry a lot easier. It's really cool. Let me just find an example. Boom. I can, on piano roll, I can do MIDI in. I can go back to step input. And now if I hold a whole note and press C, where did it go? Oh, hold on. Oh, there. I think it's because OBS right now is running. It's kind of messing with it. But I've done this before. You know, you press whatever key you want, and it puts it into the recording. So the step input thing's really cool too. Yeah, so that about covers this in terms of how, like, that my setup for my Stream Deck. I'll zoom in a bit. There's a few things that I'm gonna need to edit a bit. A few key commands that I thought I had in there that I didn't. But overall, it's still saving me so much time, especially in the organizational front. Getting things, you know, looking clean and organized and having everything where it's supposed to be. But the step input for me has been really nice. The selection tools, lot of good stuff on here. And so that's kind of just showing you how to go about it. It's really simple. Once you have your Stream Deck, once you make a profile for Logic Pro X, and you can do that by going on Edit Profiles. You're going to press plus. It's going to come up. You select the application, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to delete that. I don't need that. And then once you do that, you can make it as detailed or as simple as you want. Maybe you only have a few things that you just want to have at hand. In that case, all you're going to need to do is just drag the hotkeys in and put them there, and then just you know, have the command. Let me just find one. You know, like, boom, there's the hotkey, and you would just assign it. Or you can make it, you know, more detailed, where you have folders within folders that, you know, do that kind of thing. So it's really as powerful as you want to make it. Now, if you don't want to go through that whole process, and it takes a while, if you really want this thing to be working to its full capacity, you should give it some time and really delve into it. And I highly recommend putting a lot of effort in, because once you do that, you have all of this stuff at your fingertips to use. If you don't feel like doing that, then consider joining becoming a patron of mine on Patreon. I'm gonna put a whole bunch of Stream Deck profiles on, so that if you don't feel like, you know, programming this all yourself, I'm gonna upload them on there. I'm going to continue to upload them whenever I make some edits, so that, you know, if there's new key commands that I think are useful, I'll put them on there, and then you can go back and download them again. My Patreon channel is mostly going to be about kind of making music videos about, you know, composing, music theory, that kind of thing. But it's also going to have, you know, things like this kind of useful things for, you know, whether it's Logic or Finale, or I want to do some videos on composing for instruments that are not within the traditional Western canon. So yeah, I've got some cool things on the mend. But for right now, if you're wanting to bypass all the work of getting your Stream Deck profile up and running, consider becoming a patron, and you'd be able to download those files right away. All right, that's about it. Take care. Hope you're staying safe during these crazy times.